Here is the total global debt as at May 2023, and here is the same data with a different animation. Which one are you looking at? If you're looking at this one, then you've got a great taste for animation, and that is why I'm going to show you how to create the same animation in PowerPoint. Before we begin, I want to express my gratitude to all 445 subscribers of this channel. Your subscription gives me the opportunity to share my knowledge and experience, something I truly enjoy doing. And speaking of enjoyment, it was fun creating this tutorial. It all began with a simple text box. Knowing how morph transition actually works, I decided to create a text box of vertical numbers. By the way, if you're new to morph transition, I have a fantastic 3-minute tutorial covering the basics of morph. Go check it out. At first, it seemed straightforward. I thought, I just need to duplicate the slide, move the numbers around, apply morph transition, and I am good to go. Yet, when I ran slideshow, it scrolled, but I realized it was only the beginning. I knew for this to make sense, I have to improve the animation and use the numbers in a context. So, I challenged myself and decided, okay, why not display the total global debt, which stands at $305 trillion as at May 2023. Challenge accepted. So, I created two copies of the numbers, giving me a total of three groups of numbers. The first group will scroll to 3, second group to 0, and the third group to 5. Then I move them to the left because I want the numbers to scroll on the left side of the slide. Ideally, it should be on the position where we have 555. To help with that, I enable PowerPoint guides. In fact, I created a few more horizontal guides as you can see. Then I made the numbers bold and aligned them along the vertical and horizontal guides. With the numbers aligned, I went ahead and duplicated the slide and moved the numbers vertically until 305 is within the guides. And finally, I opened Transitions tab and applied Morph Transition. As you can see, only the first two numbers scroll because I didn't alter the position of the third numbers, and that's because 5 is already where I want it to be. So how did you fix it, you're probably asking. Well, first I deleted the slide and reversed the order of the numbers in the third group. Then I moved the group up until the number 2 is on the guides, but I didn't stop there. I created a copy of the slide once again and move the numbers until I reach 305. By reordering the third group, I could move it down to get to 5. And when I applied morph, the animation played out exactly the way I envisioned it. Pretty cool, right? But no one is going to buy this because in a real number scroller, the numbers behind are hidden. So once again, I deleted the second slide and changed the numbers on the guides from 552 to 000. Because we start counting from 0, right? After that, I reach out to a familiar tool, rectangle, drew it to cover the top half of the slide, and change its color to match the color of the slide. Then repeat the same step for the bottom half. As a final touch, I introduce some text to provide some context. If you have been following, then you'll know I'm going to duplicate the slide. Move the numbers until we have 305. And when I applied morph transition, the puzzle came together to deliver an impressive number scrolling animation. Want to try it yourself? Email 305 to hello@incrediskill.com and I will send it to you. I'll see you in the next one.